Lisa, thank you so much for being with us today, for making the trek. This is such a huge conversation for our nation right now. Freedom in the courts. We've had your colleague, John Carpe, with us a couple times. But tell us a little bit about yourself and why you got involved for the fight for freedom in Canada.
Well, it's... I have a bit of a strange backstory for a lawyer. I did practice for about 7 years when I was younger, and then I had children, so I stepped away from practice for a while. And I ended up homeschooling my kids. So while I was doing that, I was paying attention to things going on in the legal world as well, and I was doing some contract work and so on. But I, as the kids got a little more independent with their studies, I had time to watch the culture war start to unfold. And became aware of increasing encroachments on our freedoms. And then it hit very close to home when, as I was about to resume going back to practicing law in 2017, our law society that governs all of the lawyers in the profession came out with a new edict that all lawyers and paralegals in the province had to swear a statement of principles that they would promote equality, diversity, and inclusion in their practices, in their personal lives, and even in their retirement. And I thought, first of all, I mean, those sound like very nice words, but why is our legal regulator telling us what we have to believe? That can't be right. They're there to make sure we don't defraud the public, that we're competent to practice law. Why on earth are they trying to get into our heads and tell us what our principles are? Our principles are things that we develop over our lifetime as we thoughtfully consider what our views are. Mm-hmm. And we have the freedom to do that, at least I thought. Mm-hmm. So I initiated a pushback effort against the Law Society, which started with a website, and eventually we didn't manage to change the Law Society's mind on it, but we ended up taking the Law Society over effectively through the democratic process. We put together a slate of candidates who were willing to stand up and oppose that statement of principles, and they won the election. So,
wow, so that led me. Works.
It does. It did in that instance. So after that, then I decided, well, I'm kind of keen to get back to practicing law now. And I started my own practice. And then about a month later, I connected with John and Jay Cameron, one of the members of the legal team, to say I would be happy to help with some of these freedom cases because I'm really fired up about it. And they said, why don't you come aboard and be part of the team? So
amazing. And the team has been growing because there's such a need.
Absolutely.
In our nation. So what's your read of the court nationally? You talked about what was happening in Ontario with law, but what about what's the temperature nationally, in your opinion?
In terms of freedom?
Yeah.
Well, you know, I think it's something that we always have to be on guard about. You know, we should never really stop being on guard, because I think, you know, the tyranny runs deep in the heart of man, and if we don't take steps to protect our fundamental freedoms, they will erode over time or quickly sometimes. But this isn't something that's new. We've always had to be on guard for these things. So in terms of cases, we're seeing all sorts now of cases where government actors, libraries, universities are trying very hard to constrain what the ideas are that are allowed to take hold in our society. So I think that's part of the problem is we've come to a place in society where there really is a battle for ideas. There's a void that has developed. And because some people do like to control what other people can think and believe, we are finding that the discourse, if you don't believe a certain thing, if you don't follow a certain sort of progressive view of the world, your views shouldn't be heard. And I think Christians have been on the front line of this battle because their views are considered to not be sufficiently progressive in order to be given an airing. So oftentimes those are the views that are on the front line, as it were. Pro-life groups often find that their freedom to express their views publicly are being curtailed. So we have a variety of cases that we do across the country. Religious ones are part of them, but not exclusively. There are plenty of places where government agents are trying to curtail what we're allowed to say in public.
Wow, it's very eye-opening. Now, in a moment here, we are going to show a montage of some clips from John Carpe and one of the senior leaders of your team, talking about some of the different cases that are happening in Canada. I'd love to get your feedback on that. And also, you yourself are working on a very important case coming out of Ottawa that I'd love to talk about as well. And we will do that right after this.
Justin Trudeau has indicated that he wants to see a bill against conversion therapy. So the concern is that by putting gender identity in there, you're going to prevent cautious therapists from allowing a child to grow into the body that they were born into.
June 2020, something incredible is happening. The Canada Summit for National Progress. This is a strategic gathering for people who love Canada and want to see it reach its full potential. At the summit, you will hear from knowledgeable speakers who are experts in their fields, giving insight into some of our nation's biggest challenges. Then together, participants will dream and strategize, looking for ideas to solve these challenges through policies, inventions, innovations, or community initiatives. Some of these ideas will be launched right at the summit to impact the lives of Canadians for the better. We believe that the Canada Summit for National Progress could be one of the most significant transformational gatherings in our nation. Canada needs people who can face problems head on, but then look past them with a spirit of hope to find the solutions. We hope you'll join for this cutting edge gathering of dreamers, innovators, and doers. Let's build a better Canada for the future. Toronto, June 2020. To find out more or register, visit canadasummit.ca. Register soon as capacity is limited and optional VIP networking events are expected to sell out. www.canadasummit.ca.
Through the Fateen Show, we're tackling issues influencing our nation's future, like freedom of conscience, racism, poverty, the debt, human trafficking, abortion, democracy, and much more. If you missed a show, you can watch anytime at fateen.tv or on YouTube. We hope to see you there. We love Canada, and we want to see it strong for generations to come. That's why we do this show. We can't do it alone. We need your help. Unlike commercial TV, this program is 100% donor funded. If you'd like to see more episodes produced on important issues for our nation, please consider signing up to be a monthly partner or giving a special gift today. Every gift makes a real difference, and all gifts are tax deductible. Together, we can build a better Canada for the future. Visit fateen.tv or call 613-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-552-